Hello, everyone, and welcome to today's news roundup. As Canadians witness an alarming series of church burnings across the nation, there has been a growing sense of frustration over the federal government's apparent indifference. Jamil Jivani, a prominent conservative MP, has been vocal in condemning what he describes as the government's failure to address these anti-Christian hate crimes effectively. Over the past 2 years, Canada has seen more than 100 churches burned or vandalized. This disturbing trend includes incidents ranging from arson to desecration of religious symbols. Communities across the country have felt the impact, with many parishes scrambling to rebuild and reclaim their places of worship. Despite the scale of these attacks, the national response has been, at best, lukewarm. The churches affected are diverse, representing various denominations and ethnic communities. This widespread destruction underscores a troubling rise in anti-Christian sentiment, raising questions about the broader social implications and what it means for religious freedom in Canada.
Since 2021, we've had over 100 Christian churches burned, vandalized, or desecrated in Canada. And sometimes when I see that, and I see the lack of media coverage of those attacks on religious freedom, when I see that we cannot even in the House of Commons get every party to agree on condemning those attacks on religious freedom, I think to myself, like, yo, dog, are we like in the Truman Show or something right now? Like, it just seems so frustrating and puzzling how you get to this point.
The criminal acts targeting churches are not random, but seem to be a coordinated effort to spread fear among Christian communities. These hate crimes represent a specific attack on religious identity, yet they have not garnered the reaction one might expect from a government committed to protecting all its citizens. But before we dive deeper into the details, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more engaging content and updates on important issues. Jamil Jivani has been a leading voice in criticizing the government's lackadaisical approach to these crimes. Jivani argues that the Liberal and NDP coalition has failed to recognize the severity of the situation, resulting in inadequate measures being taken to prevent further attacks and support affected communities. According to Jivani, this inaction is symptomatic of a broader disregard for issues that impact conservative and religious groups. He asserts that the government's silence on these hate crimes is indicative of a deeper bias, one that marginalizes Christian voices and their concerns. Jivani has highlighted specific incidents where the government had an opportunity to take a stand but chose not to. Also, discover our exclusive collection of mugs, hoodies, and a variety of daily accessories designed for Canada Conservative Party supporters. Show your pride with our conservative-themed products at affordable prices. Enjoy free delivery across Canada. The reluctance to address these attacks on Christian churches has wider implications for how Canada responds to hate crimes targeted at other religious communities. If the government fails to take a firm stand now, it risks setting a precedent of tolerance toward religious discrimination. Such inaction can lead to an environment where faith-based communities feel unsafe and unsupported. This lack of response could embolden perpetrators of hate crimes, not just against Christians, but potentially against other religious groups as well. Jivani emphasizes that taking action now is crucial for safeguarding Canada's multicultural and religiously diverse society.
Frustrating and puzzling how you get to this point. And often I will hear from constituents who are concerned about it, and they'll say, express a sense of hopelessness, like, well, how do you get people to care about this? And then I see other communities go through their own ordeals when it comes to attacks on their religious freedom. We've seen, schools and synagogues get shot at in Montreal, or just over the weekend, we've seen the house hate-motivated attack on a Muslim family in London. And I think to myself, well, maybe there's an opportunity for us all to work together and draw attention to the various ways that faith communities in this country may experience discrimination.
Jivani is not merely critiquing the government, but also calling for concrete measures to address the problem. He proposes several steps the government could take to combat church burnings effectively. Enact legislation that specifically addresses hate crimes against religious institutions. increase funding for security measures at places of worship, similar to initiatives seen in other countries protecting synagogues and mosques. Launch a national awareness campaign to highlight the issue of anti-Christian hate crimes and educate the public on the importance of religious freedom. Collaborate with law enforcement agencies to ensure that incidents of church burnings are thoroughly investigated and perpetrators are brought to justice. These measures, according to Jivani, would demonstrate the government's commitment to protecting all religious communities and reaffirm its stance against hate-driven violence. As this issue continues to unfold, it remains to be seen whether the government will heed Jivani's calls for action or continue on its current path of relative inaction. The response to these church burnings not only affects the Christian communities directly involved, but also has far-reaching implications for religious freedom and safety in Canada. The government's next steps could either restore confidence among religious groups or further deepen the rift between them and the state. The urgency of addressing these concerns cannot be overstated. With each day that passes without a robust governmental response, the message sent to perpetrators is one of ignorance and tolerance. It is essential for the government to act decisively to not only bring justice to affected communities, but also to reaffirm its commitment to protecting the rights and freedoms of all its citizens, irrespective of their religious affiliation. But what do you think? Share your thoughts in the comments below, and let's keep this important conversation going. Also, take a minute to visit our website, sign the petition demanding Justin Trudeau leave the office immediately, and sign up for our newsletters to get uncensored news in Canadian politics. And do not forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel for more updates. The Liberal NDP coalition is pushing for the passage of Bill C-273, a legislative move that could have significant implications for parental rights and disciplinary measures in Canada. The bill, introduced by NDP MP Der Julien, aims to repeal Section 43 of the Criminal Code, which currently allows parents and teachers to use reasonable force on children in certain situations. This section has been a contentious point of discussion, particularly given its intersection with historical and contemporary practices of child discipline. Conservative MPs, including Jamil Jivani, have expressed strong objections to the bill, arguing that it undermines parental rights and could impede effective parenting. Section 43, often referred to as the spanking law, permits parents to use reasonable force to manage their children's behavior, for instance, spanking a child who reaches for a hot stovetop or holding a child to enforce a timeout. The conservatives worry that without this provision, parents and teachers might be hamstrung in their efforts to discipline children appropriately. To address these concerns, conservative MPs have proposed an amendment to Bill C-273 that would codify the Supreme Court's 2004 decision on what constitutes reasonable force. This decision prohibits the use of physical force on teenagers or children under the age of 2, the use of objects against a child of any age, slapping the head of any child, and teachers using force against children as punishment, although it allows reasonable force to remove a child from a classroom. By incorporating these standards into the bill, the amendment seeks to ensure that parental rights are preserved while aligning with contemporary child protection norms. Jamil Jivani emphasized the importance of this amendment during the committee hearing, stating, "The amendment addresses my primary concern and one that I've heard from many people, which is that Bill C-273 does not recognize or respect parental rights. Parental rights deserve recognition just as teacher safety does in any consideration of this bill, in any consideration of Section 43 of the Canadian Criminal Code. This debate over Bill C-273 also highlights broader tensions between the Liberal government and Canadian parents. Prime Minister Justin Trudeau has been criticized for dismissing parental concerns about gender ideology in schools as misinformation and right-wing propaganda. Such comments have only fueled the perception among some parents that their rights and perspectives are being ignored or marginalized. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like and share this video if you found it informative. Your engagement helps us continue creating content that explores important issues facing Canada today. For more updates, visit scoopcanada.com.